Lightning is sexist. Lightning seems to prefer to strike men over women, with about 85% of its victims being men. Surprisingly, of those struck by lightning, the fatality rates are higher in women than men. Additionally, 90% of lightning strike victims survive. Oak trees are struck by lightning more than any other tree. Oaks tend to be taller than other surrounding trees and hold more moisture naturally, making them particularly vulnerable. There are about 8.6 million strikes of lightning every day. The perfect place to see lightning strikes is Lake Maracaibo in Venezuela, where there is an 80% chance of experiencing a nocturnal thunderstorm. Sometimes lightning can be captured in a kind of frozen sand sculpture known as petrified lightning. The conditions must be just right, but if the bolt strikes a sandy beach that's high in silica or quartz, the intense temperature can cause the sand to fuse into silica glass. It results in an impressive snapshot of the bolt that might be mistaken for a tree branch. Nine out of ten lightning strikes land rather than water. A man claimed lightning restored his sight. Edwin Robinson, a resident of Falmouth, Massachusetts, was blinded by a car accident in 1971. Then, he was struck by lightning in June 1980, knocking him unconscious for 20 minutes. Upon awaking, Robinson discovered that his sight had returned. Lightning can result in forest fires. Lightning releases a bolt of electricity. Also, smoke and carbon microparticles present in the upper regions of the atmosphere can initiate static. Such static can spark discharge, turning into lightning, which has resulted in massive wildfires in the coast of Brazil, Peru, and Hawaii, burning acres of sugar cane. 10,000 forest fires in the U.S. every year are also caused by lightning. United States Park Ranger in Shenandoah National Park in Virginia. Between 1942 and 1977, Roy Sullivan was hit by lightning on 7 occasions and survived all of them. He took his own life at the age of 71. Lightning strikes the same place. It's like lightning has a highway it follows, as it often strikes the same place, especially if that location is a tall, pointed and isolated object. The Empire State Building gets struck by lightning about 23 times each year. People used to think that you could scare away lightning by ringing the church bells. So that didn't work. Not even at all. The deadly combination of sitting in a high church tower and ringing a metal bell has killed quite a few fanatical bell ringer. Ball lightning moves slower than normal lightning, and can be as big as 8 feet or 2.4 meters in diameter. They cause huge amounts of damage. At the end of the 19th century, people walked around with a lightning rod on their umbrellas. The thing consisted of a metal rod on the tip of the umbrella, to which a metal wire was attached to conduct lightning. It worked just like a real lightning rod and was intended to protect the owner during a thunderstorm. It was not a good idea. After all, Such an umbrella with a point also attracts lightning. At the time lightning strikes, it is hotter than the sun. Lightning is an electrostatic discharge, supercharged from ionized air, and as it finds its way to Earth, it releases massive bolts of electricity. The temperature of lightning can reach 30,000 degrees Celsius, about 5 times hotter than the surface of the sun. George Wilhelm Richman was a Russian imperial physicist. He proved that thunderclouds contain electric charge. He was electrocuted while trying to quantify the response of an insulated rod to a nearby storm. He was attending a meeting of the Academy of Sciences, when he heard thunder. The professor ran home with his engraver to capture the event for posterity. While the experiment was underway, a supposed ball lightning appeared and collided with Richman's head, leaving him dead with a red spot on his forehead, his shoes blown open, and parts of his clothes singed. An explosion followed like that of a small cannon that knocked the engraver out, split the room's door frame, and tore the door off its hinges. Reportedly, ball lightning traveled along the apparatus and was the cause of his death. He was apparently the first person in history to die while conducting electrical experiments. Lightning is not only spectacular, it's dangerous. About 2,000 people are killed worldwide by lightning each year. Hundreds more survive strikes but suffer from a variety of lasting symptoms, including memory loss, dizziness, weakness, numbness, and other life-altering ailments. Strikes can cause cardiac arrest and severe burns, but 9 of every 10 people survive. The average American has about a 1 in 5,000 chance of being struck by lightning during a lifetime. When an unexpected event happens, people describe it as a bolt from the blue. The phrase is actually based on real weather phenomena where a lightning bolt will strike an area with no overhead clouds. While bolts from the blue don't originate from blue sky, they occur infrequently, are unexpected, and can be deadly. A bolt from the blue is cloud-to-ground lightning. A bolt from the blue usually starts from the top of a cloud which is positively charged. It occurs when there is too much positive charge at the top of the cloud and a discharge is needed for balance. As a result of the charge being positive, the strike carries more power, can reach longer distances, and is hotter than a negative strike. It is not only the power that poses a danger, it is the unexpectedness. A bolt from the blue can strike as far as 40 kilometers away from the nearest storm cloud. As a result, people in the open may not think they are at risk. For outdoor activities such as golf or working at heights, it is especially dangerous. One bolt of lightning once killed 81 people. On December 8, 1963, a lightning bolt hit the left wing of Pan American Flight 214, heading from Puerto Rico to Philadelphia. The bolt ignited the fuel stored in the plane's reserve tank, causing an explosion and part of the wing to separate from the plane. The whole thing came crashing down, and all 81 passengers were killed. Being struck by lightning gives you a rash. The rash that lightning leaves behind on those it strikes is probably the least of victims' worries, but they are pretty gnarly. The tree-like red branching pattern known as Lichtenberg figures is caused by the electrical charge rupturing capillaries beneath the skin. The rash is named for German physicist Professor George Lichtenberg, who discovered the pattern on electrically charged plates. They are sometimes also called lightning flowers or skin feathering.